Myself, Shikha dugar, working as an assistant professor in Biyani Girls College, welcomes you all on behalf of GuruKpo.com. Today, I am going to discuss about this topic, which is very, very, very important in today's organization. And the topic is change management and its strategies. Now, I want to ask you one thing, that what is change and what is the only thing which is permanent in an organization? The word change. Change is the only thing which is permanent in any organization, not only in the organization, in everywhere, everywhere. Why? Because if we do not change ourselves, if we do not change our organization, if there is no change in the environment, then we will not move forward. So, change is the very, very, very important thing which should be there in any organization. Now, what is change basically? The change is unfreezing the older things and moving up with the change. Now, what is unfreezing? Unfreezing is taking out from our mind, taking out the old things, all the older versions which we are using in the organization, like the technology, like the culture, like the values, like the climate, everything we have to change, so that we can move forward in today's era. Now, what are the change management strategies? How we can bring change in any organization? As I have said earlier, that change is important, but how we will bring the change in the organization? There are some of the strategies, and apart from this, there are many other strategies also, which I am going to discuss it right now. The first and the foremost is, propose incentive. Everybody in our organization here comes to for our growth and for our value and for our career opportunities. But the first and foremost thing which we want, every individual wants, if we are working, then we want money. So the financial incentives are very important for each and every employee to move forward in the organization and to give his or her 100% inputs. So, first of all, we'll introduce this change with the help of this incentives. Say, for example, if I said anyone that if you'll do this thing like the new with the help of new technology, I'll give you this kind of incentive. So, this thing will motivate me or the any other individual, and he or she will definitely do that work with the change model. The second is redefine cultural values. Every organization has his or culture, the norms, the values, the ethics which every individual has to follow. So, change should be also inbuilt in this culture values, so that each and every will follow that particular thing in the organization. That means, if I am here in the organization, this is the cultural value of this organization, that every individual has to follow the change, has to accept the change with wholeheartedly. The third one is exercise authority. Now, this is very important. Why? Because every individual is, as we all are human beings, and we have the inbuilt nature or the attitude that someone will boost me, or someone will guide me, or someone will mentor me to do something. So an authority is always should be there, so that he can exercise change in the day-to-day working. And an authority should be there to give the feedback, or to just watch, or to control the things which are not going up to the mark. And the next is shift the burden of change. Now, what is that? Shift the burden of change. That means change, we can shift the burden of change to not only to one individual, but we can divide the things in the different department, within the people, between the groups, so that every individual should understand the value and importance of change, and he or she will motivate each and everyone. So we have to shift the burden of change from one individual to group of individuals, or to group of departments, or to group of the teams, so that everyone will come together and will do the change and will do the needful to bring the change. And the next is recruit champions of change. Now, what are those? If I'll recruit, if I'll recruit a negative person or a person who is very rigid or who is very stubborn, that I'll not accept any kind of change, or that if I'm working in a way, in a manner from the last 5 years and I'll do that or in the same manner for the next 50 years, that is not possible. So I have, as the employer, if I would have an employer of any company, I'll recruit those person who are ready to accept the change, it's himself, and he'll motivate the other person also, so that he or she can motivate the other person also for the change, to bring the change. Apart from these strategies, there are also some of the strategies which are, say for example, workers participation and management. If I'll make the participation of workers or the employees in the management decision, so they will think that they are the part and parcel of the organization, they'll feel the sense of belongingness, which is very important, and then only they'll accept the change. If they will know the importance of change, or if they will be the part of the management, then only they can know the importance of change or the why change is important if in any organization, then only they'll accept and they will pass on these things to the their colleagues, to the peers, or to the group members. And the other method is the model which we should accept. And what are those? What is that? The change model: unfreezing, moving, and rephrasing. What are this? Unfreezing is taking out the older things from the mind or from the insight of an individual. Then we'll introduce the change, that is the second stage, that is moving. And the last is rephrasing. Now, what is that? Rephrasing is fixing the new version, taking out the older version and fixing the new version, new methods, new technology, that is rephrasing. The other thing which we can do is the icebreakers or the management games. What are icebreakers? Icebreakers are breaking the ice. Now, what is breaking the ice? Breaking the things which we have already fitted in our mind from the last many years, so that we can empty our mind and we can refill our mind with the new versions. So these are some of the strategies with the help of these strategies we can introduce change in any of the organization, and which is very important. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please like, share, or comment, and subscribe for this channel. Thank you so much.